Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. So in today's session we'll discuss about a few representations and notations which we are going to use in automata theory. So in the previous session we have discussed about the basic concept of automata, that means a model or a machine which runs in a finite number of states, that is called a finite automata, and this automata is nothing but a machine or a model, right? And now we'll see the representations, different representations which we are going to be used in the further sessions of automata theory. And the first one is symbol. First we need to know about symbol. So here the symbol represents the alphabets A, comma B, comma C, etc., or 0, 1, 2, etc. So either alphabets or the numericals, any character will be represented as a symbol. And the next one is alphabet. Alphabet. So alphabet is generally represented as a sigma, and it is a collection of symbols. It is a collection of symbols. Right? For example, alphabet is equal to some A comma B. This is one alphabet over A comma B. Similarly, sigma is equal to alphabet 0 comma 1. So this is another alphabet. Binary alphabet, we can simply call it as a binary alphabet, right? So this is the alphabet. It's a collection of symbols, a collection of symbols. And the next one is string. String. So generally we know that a string is a group of characters, right? So here the string is a collection of symbols, right? A string is a collection of symbols. Over alphabet, right? That's the difference. Over an alphabet. So here also it's a collection of symbols, right? So here we are using some A and B, right? Is a symbol. 0 and 1, it's also an alphabet, right? But here the string is a collection of symbols over the alphabet, because so here the collection of symbols can be any symbol, right? But here the string will be having a collection of symbols over the alphabet. That means if you use this one, sigma is equal to A comma B, so we need to represent the string with a combination of only A and B. That means a collection of symbols over alphabet. So this is the alphabet. From this alphabet, we have to give the string. That means a combination of symbols. For example, so here the string, the possible strings can be A is one string, B can be another string, A, B is another string, B, A is another string, B, B, so A, B, so etc. So this is nothing but the possible strings over this alphabet. Okay, the possible strings over this alphabet. So this is called the string, a collection of alphabets. Next, the next one is language. So language is usually, it will be represented as L, and this L will be having all the strings, possible strings over the alphabet will comes under this language. So it is a collection or set of all strings, set of all strings over alphabet is called a language. So that language can be having the set of all possible strings. So here we can have a multiple number of strings. We can have a multiple number of strings, that is the infinite, because here there is no specified length, right? So this is an infinite length. So all these strings combinedly known as L. So a set of all strings over the alphabet, right? Now, so if you consider this example, so L is equal to, it is nothing but a set of all the strings. So L is equal to, so we can use A, B, A, B, A, B, 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 A, and a three digit, three symbols, okay, length three, okay. So A, B, 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 A, A, etc. So after the 3 length, we'll go with the 4 length, right? So this is called a language. Language is a set of all strings over the given alphabet. So if the alphabet is 0, 1, we'll be having the combination of all the zeros and ones. The strings will be having the combination of zeros and ones. Okay. Now, hope you understood about these things. So what is meant by the symbol, alphabet, string and the language. Now, the next one is clean star. Clean star. So clean star is usually represented as sigma star. Sigma star. So which is also called as universal set. Universal set or universal language. Universal language. So this sigma star is nothing but sigma star is equal to, it can be calculated as sigma 0 union sigma 1 union sigma 2 and so on. Sigma star is equal to sigma naught union sigma 1. So where this sigma 0 means length of strings. Length of strings must be 0. Length of strings must be 0. And this we usually called as null string. Null string or empty string. Null string or empty string. So this a null or empty string is represented as epsilon. Null string or empty string is represented as epsilon. So here epsilon means length of string is 0. Length of string is 0. So this is also included in clean star. That means sigma star. This should be also be included in clean star. And similarly, hope you understood this sigma 0. Now we'll go with the sigma 1. So if you consider sigma 1, the length of the strings must be 1. The length of the string must be 1. So usually the length of strings must be, if the length of string is 1, so what are the possible strings? For example, if you take the alphabet as A comma B, you take the alphabet as A comma B. Now from this alphabet, so consider or construct all the strings with length is equal to 1. So simply we can say A comma B, these are the strings which can be possible with this alphabet of string of length 1. Now sigma 2. So here the sigma 2 means length of strings, all the strings with 2. Length of all strings with 2. So the combination of A and B of length 2. So we can simply write it as A comma A, AB, BA, BB. This is the length of the string. Now, so here you can see the sigma star is equal to all the strings with length 0, that means epsilon. All the strings with length 1, that is A comma B. All the strings with length 2, so AA. So here we will get only, right, AA, AB, BA, BB. So, and then the length of strings 3 and so on. So you can say this one, right? So that's why this is called an infinite set and it's a universal set. So this clean star will be having all possible strings over the alphabet A comma B. Right? Over the alphabet A comma B. So it will accept all the strings, okay, with a different length. Now there's a one more concept called, so hope you understood this clean star, right? So including the length of strings with 0, that means a null string. And there is one more concept called clean closure. Clean closure. So which is represented as sigma plus. Sigma plus. So here the sigma plus can be defined as, so this is a subset of this universal set, because so sigma star minus epsilon is called a sigma plus. Sigma star minus epsilon means, so it will also accept all the strings with a different length but excluding the null string. So that means it should not accept the strings with length 0. Okay, this is epsilon is nothing but a null string. So we should not include that null string inside the epsilon star. So that is called a clean closure. So this can be written as sigma plus is equal to sigma star minus sigma naught. Sigma star minus sigma naught. And once again, we can also write this one as sigma 1 union sigma 2 union sigma 3 and so on. So what we have done? So we are started union from 1 itself. So length 1, length 2, length 3 and so on. So this is called a clean closure, sigma plus, right? Now, so the language, we'll see a small example for this language and we'll close. Hope you understood this basic concepts. So if construct a language which accepts strings, strings with length 2 over the alphabet 0, 1. So this is the question. Okay, this is the question. So we need to have the language which accepts the strings with length 2 over sigma is equal to 0, 1. So here the sigma is 0, 1 and we have to construct all the strings of this particular language. So language L is equal to, so it should have the strings with the length 2. So here you can see the alphabets are 0, 1. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So this is the language of length 2. If we take length 3, so we'll get, so 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. Right? So these are the different languages. Okay, these are the different strings that can be formed from this particular alphabet. So you can see whether L or, I mean, see here you write L2 and here you write L3. L2 means length 2, length 3. So both are finite languages. Finite languages. Right? So we can't say that every language will be a finite. So that can be a finite or infinite. Okay. Now we'll see the strings with a length greater than or equal to 2. So if it is greater than or equal to 2, you can see L4 is equal to, so we can have the length greater than or equal to 2, that means sigma 2 union sigma 3 union sigma 4 and so on. That means we have to collect all the strings with length 2, next length 3, next length 4, length 5 and so on. So that implies, so this will be, it is a infinite language. It will be the infinite language, right? So what I have to say is, so language will not be infinite for all the cases. So in some cases it will be the finite language, in some cases it will be the infinite language, right? And so that's why we can say that language is the subset of sigma star, that means a clean star, right? So hope you understood this one. And one more thing I just want to say, if you consider the string as a W, then the length of a string is represented as placing W in between two vertical bars. So this represents the length of the string, right? And hope you understood. These are the a few basic representations and notations which we are going to use in the further sessions of automata theory. So I will stop here. Hope you understood this one. So we have seen what is a symbol, what is an alphabet, what is a language, what is a string, what is a clean star, what is a clean closure, right? So, and the string representation, length of the string representation, right? So if you are having any doubts regarding this one, feel free to post your doubts in the comment section. Definitely I'll try to clarify all your doubts. And if you really enjoyed my session, like my session, share my session with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. Thank you very much.